Listen, we need to stall anyway, all right? Because Esfand needs to log on, and we need to get everybody together for the dungeons anyway, all right? So the servers are down. We might as well just start this and get it done. Let me, before I start this at all, let me take a drink and get started. All right, guys? New pause record? No, there's been one time where I paused the video at 1 second in.
Hey guys, what's up? Mad Season here, back with another video for you. I have a rather interesting subject for you today, I think. I'm going to talk about Classic. I know, crazy, right? So, with all of the recent updates, we've gotten some information on what's changed and what hasn't, and we're starting to get a pretty good picture of how Classic is shaping up so far.
God, I need to fix
this. Pretty close
I don't know
to
why
the
that's
original.
Happening now. Never
However,
happened before.
There are some confirmed differences. Some of them are in Blizzard's control,
apologize, but...
and some aren't, and I thought it would make for an interesting video to sort of compile it here for you. Not just from the blue posts, too. This is from the perspective of someone who's been playing since March of 2005 and has seen the game change over
it's
the past
It's like everybody's
decade,
played longer than me, and
I
played for like
15
years.
Things that maybe you haven't thought of yet.
Look at that gear,
I'll also
dude.
Be ranking them, as I think it's more interesting.
Let me turn
It'll
it
be
up.
In the order of substantiality, increasing as the video progresses.
Okay.
So, starting at number 10 here, we have add-ons and their usage. Now, it was confirmed that the add-on system is already going to be different. Basically, it's a mix of the old and the new to try and make it authentic, but at the same time, introduce some limits since there were fewer restrictions in
Thank
vanilla.
God.
Typically, in the realm of automation, with the presence of one-button rotations.
See?
Going
See?
Past that, though, over the years, add-ons have grown just like the game has.
Look at this! Look at this frame, man! Oh my god! Dude, I love this. Like, whenever I see videos like this, they're absolutely amazing. The screenshots.
And people have become more adept
I used to
at
have this
creating
one too.
Them, and some that existed only after Vanilla's original run will surely see a release for the official remake.
The more
remake.
Add-ons you have, the better of a
they're
raider you are.
They're almost limitless, but possibly the biggest one in regards to the balance of the game will be the boss mods.
Oh,
now,
yeah.
Now, these did exist in Classic, but as I've said, these authors have become much better over time. And have had nearly 15
they
years
make it
of practice
where you can't have
to
boss
make
mods.
The ultimate raid helper add-ons.
No boss mods in Classic.
And going past that,
Period.
There was actually a stigma
Zero.
Against mods for a short while there, if you can actually believe that. I think this was more during
World
the early
of
stages
Chiefs.
Of Classic.
I need to go to that website.
There were people who thought that these unlicensed add-ons were essentially cheats,
yeah, take a look at that.
And they refused to download them. Sometimes they thought that they were against the terms of service and that they'd be banned by Blizzard.
Accurate.
And other times, it was more of a matter of pride. In disgust, they'd question the ability of those dirty add-on users. Like, ugh, you need an add-on to tell you what to do with this boss? My skill is my add-on, okay, buddy?
I used to say that until Siegecrafter Blackfuse, I believe. Because I needed an add-on for Siegecrafter Blackfuse, but all the way up until then, I never played with add-ons. I never had any DBM or anything.
It didn't matter if he was the dude who'd somehow die within
yep.
the first 5 seconds
that
of
was,
every fight.
That, no, it's not me.
He
that
may
was
have
not
been
me.
The Glass Joe of World of Warcraft.
I would never die.
But he was a purist, damn it.
Never, never
Some
would
of you
die.
May remember the drama with the old quest-helping add-ons.
Oh,
Waypoints
yeah.
Waypoints to mark the quest's locations.
Yep.
What is this? Weenie Hut Jr.?
Absolutely
oh,
disgusting.
Oh, how the times have changed. So,
they
add-ons
certainly
and the community surrounding it. Number 10 on our list. And coming in at number 9, we have streamers. Over the years,
okay.
the realm of gaming has transformed.
Okay.
Back then, when I played 12 hours a day, people would just make fun of me. But today, there's a whole industry designed around playing video games
well, they
and
make fun
commenting
of me
over
too.
Them. These
it's
streamers
new.
Are looked at as gods in whatever game they play, and
yep.
they have whole communities at their beck and call. Where they play, their fans play, and it'll have a notable effect on whatever server they decide to
we
play
like
on.
We like Fortnite!
Come on, baby.
That was me trying to recruit everybody for the Arathi Highlands battle last night, or the other day. And this is everybody in Stormwind, and I was up there flossing, and nobody gave a fuck.
I want to see some movement. I'm not seeing enough movement. Oh my god.
I actually saw a video about this recently by a guy named
we
Classic Wins, and he made some really good points, I thought. Looking to become a scepter bearer when the Encourage war effort starts?
Not on my server.
You'll essentially be racing a streamer and his hundreds
yep.
of fans helping
yep.
him grind through it. seeing cues to get into your server, that screenshot dirty streamer must be playing again. The completely pure and unsullied trade chat is now being spammed Poggers. With Twitch memes. Thanks, streamer.
I hate Poggers.
You happened to snake a mining node from him and are now getting harassed by their crazy fans. Thanks,
yep.
streamer.
Yep.
You have a small wiener. Thanks, streamer.
Yep.
Or, I mean, well, maybe you're on a PvP server and you decide to get back at him by ganking him, but you can't get past his personal 24/7 escort. Or maybe you just happen to be leveling in the same zone as him, and you can't get a single cactus apple to save your life. Or maybe your server is dying because the streamer quit, and all of their fans joined him. And it goes on and on.
I wonder what's going to happen with that.
The subject interests you.
Like, I do wonder what's going to happen with that. Like, I'll pause that and talk about it. Because, like, what if, like, somebody who's, like, a really, really big streamer starts playing on a server, and then they quit that server? And, like, Darkspear, like, that's actually what happened with Darkspear, right? Because, like, Swifty, like, whenever he stopped, like, didn't he transfer off of Darkspear or something? Or I forgot what it was. And, like, that server went from being, like, that was where everything was happening to where that was where nothing was happening. And it was insane. Just because of, like, one person.
Good.
You better
I'll
never
have it
quit.
Linked in the description.
Don't worry.
Don't take this as whining, by the way. I don't have anything against streamers. If they're bringing new blood to the scene, it's actually good for the game. And they have the right to do whatever they want, just like everyone else. And a lot. A lot of the times, I think the problems are caused more
the
by
funny
fans
part is you're doing it right
the streamers
now.
Streamers themselves.
What do you mean?
But still, it's substantial.
You're
enough,
reacting
and
right now.
Wasn't a thing
it, so it's a it's a
release.
It's a joke
thus
inside of
spot on this
what
list,
is actually happening.
Oh, come on, man.
And coming in at number 8.
What are you
going
to stop reacting
bugs,
to shit, dude?
Glitches,
the servers are down.
Exploits. Anything unintended really can go into this spot. This was something that was confirmed by Blizzard various times. The most recent being their update with itemization, where they made mention of Ragnaros only getting killed.
You know what? You know what? Fuck you, McConnell. You wanna farm gear all day. He left the channel. He left the fucking channel. He's listening to stream. Listen to this, McConnell. You farm gear all fucking day and night.
Yeah, that's right.
All fucking day and night. And
that's
you
right.
do me, and you
that's
know
right.
I won't expect you, and you win, and you talk shit.
That's right.
I fucking love Classic,
hey,
man.
Why don't you shut the fuck up, okay? You had the beta 2 days more
well,
I than
to,
I did.
I had to take time
you
off,
had
man.
Oh, you had to. Okay. Sure, what? You. I know what you do off stream, okay? And it ain't that fucking important, okay? Trust me.
Don't trust them, guys. It's very, very important. I had an extremely important meeting I had to go to yesterday that lasted all night long, okay? So keep that in mind. I didn't have time to play.
I don't think anybody believes you go all night long, buddy. Okay, not anymore.
...to a glitch with one of his abilities. If you wiped on him, sometimes he wouldn't reset properly for the next attempt, and he'd lose access to his Lava Burst spell, making the fight much easier, which resulted in some guilds killing him prematurely. And they also brought up the infamous pre-nerf C'Thun,
I bet people
who was
could
deemed
kill him.
Unkillable by the player base, assuming
I
the
bet
best
people
gear
could kill him
and
now.
Perfect play.
100%.
These unintended quirks 150%. Didn't stop in raids, though. Putting game exploits aside, we also had things such as wall walking. Up until patch 2.4,
oh,
when
yeah.
butting up against a wall, players could sometimes stick to it and
yeah.
reach places developers had not impossible to reach. Some classic examples would be the old Mount Hygel in Kalimdor.
We're
and
going
Ironforge
there today.
Airport in Dunmoreau.
We are going there today, by the way. I want to say
there
that.
There was
right.
also a short while where players could get an extra talent point, making it possible to get both their 31 point and 21 point talents.
That's a Pat Warrior PvP video right there.
I remember that Warriors in particular were pretty ridiculous because they could get both Mortal Strike and Deathwish.
No, they weren't ridiculous.
And this even includes things such
Wasn't
as stability.
Ridiculous.
Now, I can't predict the future. Who knows how the launch will go? But the hardware, of course, has improved tremendously over the years.
Okay.
This should result in less lag in general for the average player and less server downtime, which was all too common back then. The servers
That's
went
good.
Under maintenance every Tuesday, as it does today, but they'd be down for several hours if you were lucky. Sometimes they ran into issues, and it took them days, and the forums were always a sight to behold.
Yep.
People threatening to quit, demanding refunds.
I actually think this shit is so funny, because if you go on the forums today, it's the same posts. Blizzard is cheating its customers. Warriors are too overpowered. Viewing blue responses needs to be easier. Can we get some official definition? Definition. Yeah, definition. It's been like 15 years. The forums are exactly the same, saying the exact same things. Losing job because of WoW? Hey, there it is. But except this time around, it's people that actually work on the game. It's kind of a bad joke, but unfortunately, it's not a fucking joke, so I'm going to make it anyway. Fucking Blizzard firing people. Communities, managers, like this. Can you believe that, dude? Too soon? I don't know, man.
It got so bad that they actually started to hand out free game time to players if it was down long enough.
I've gotten a lot of one-day credits.
It's not all on Blizzard's end as well. This was still the dark ages of the internet for a lot of people.
Now that I've gotten on the internet, I'd rather be on my computer than doing just about anything.
It's really cool.
The internet gave us a whole world of exciting new possibilities. Porn. So I guess this is a story of how it changed our lives. Maybe
fuck
it will
yeah,
yours
dude.
Too, with the Kid's Guide to the Internet.
Take a spin, now you're in with the techno set. You're going surfing on the internet.
You see, Mad Season added that fucking thing? That one wasn't actually on there. He added that. That was actually really funny.
We're talking AOL online levels, where if your mom got on the phone, you'd be kicked off in the middle of a boss fight, or fapping to erotic pictures that...
We were the first... My house was the first house to have internet on my whole street. Out of all my friends, I had internet and no one else did. And you know what that meant? Everyone would come over to my house to watch porn on the weekends whenever my mom was asleep. It was like, and like everybody, we had like this one rule where you had to use the bathroom. Everybody, it's like if you had to pee or anything, because you couldn't do it while we were watching. It was like, man. Wait, oh my mom is fucking downstairs. I don't know if she shit, dude, but listen. That shit was fucking amazing. Like, we did it all day, dude. We even looked up porn on Newgrounds. Like, oh my god. Okay, alright.
Or fapping to erotic pictures that took 5 minutes to load.
Yep.
You better hope that most of the action was in the top half, or you'd be screwed. So, it's a rather broad brush here, but
okay.
Most of the bugs, glitches, or otherwise unintended quirks of the game won't be seeing a return in Official Classic.
That makes sense.
And moving on to number 7, we have the community.
Look at them all!
Now, I think the community
Holy
aspect
shit.
Will be largely similar to how it was during Classic
Fuck
in
yeah,
its basic
Will.
Form. And what I mean by that Hell is yeah, that most Will. Of the tools that sort of diluted it are absent, save for the limited
Look
layering,
at that, man.
More on that in a bit. But the leveling is tougher, and thus the player interaction
that's a quest
is encouraged.
Yes, that's for
and
the
there's no dungeon,
the ogres.
Nor raid finder, thus player interaction is encouraged. And there's no mob sharing, thus player interaction is encouraged. And there's no cross-realm grouping, which means you'll only see the people who are on your server. So
yo, I actually just thought of that. That's completely fucking true. The mob tagging and like being able to share mob tags with other people, Blizzard's intention was to make it more social, and so you would help other people, but it's actually made things less social, because that way people will just tag the mob and walk by, and they'll never take the time to group and coordinate and interact with each other. That's actually insane. I've never even thought of that. What the fuck?
Now you have a reputation, either positive
fair.
Or negative,
yeah.
And consequences to your actions. The tools are there, but a simple fact of life is that people change.
Yep.
It's nearly 14 years since the World of Warcraft has released, and we're in a new generation, and the way that people conduct themselves has changed as well. Voice programs are now free to everyone, whereas back then, it was a luxury, and only the most dedicated guilds
speak.
Would own one to coordinate raids.
Yep, I had
those
this too.
Codecs that made everyone sound like robots.
Holy shit, man.
So,
Ragnaros basically has two phases.
This is completely inaccurate because there's no game cam down here. There's no watermark, and there's also no Fraps website on the top. So we automatically know this is not a real vanilla WoW video.
The sun's come up, and everyone needs to get over
unregistered hypercam too.
And we need to alien down. We do have an AoE mana burn.
Typing in the notepad with desktop capture.
Now we have Discord, where with one click of a button, people can create, invite, or join a free and lightweight program to quickly and easily chat with fellow group or raid members. Gone are the days where guild websites were mandatory, and you were required to fill out an application to join or read a lengthy guild charter it was a job interview or something.
Dude, I used to love this shit. Like, straight up, like, I loved having, like, guild websites and guild interviews. I used to do guild interviews for my guild. This was actually one of my favorite parts of the game. Like, my favorite parts of WoW aren't even WoW. They're what comes out of WoW. And, like, all the social interactions and, like, the hierarchies and the structure in it and, like, all of that kind of stuff. Like, that's my favorite part of the game. It's like the bosses, the PvP, I don't really give, I mean, like, it's cool, right? But it's really about having, like, I don't know, man. I just think it's so cool that there's, like, a completely different world out there with, like, completely different social expectations. And it's, like, almost an alternate parallel dimension to, like, the real life. And I don't know, I think it's really cool. That's what I've always really liked about video games and, like, online MMOs.
I'm sure you'll still see this
stuff
here and there.
It's kind of like a post-apocalyptic society.
It'll be much more rare compared to back then. And going past that, though, people's knowledge of the game will be greater, and they'll be more skilled, and thus less likely to request aid from other players compared to our first time through. There'll be a large group of returning players, I'm sure. That's sort of the target audience of the game.
Can we read it?
And I think the community will be much more tight-knit compared to, say, the current game. The environment to foster it is in place. There's just that unavoidable stuff, such as knowledge and skill, that'll have an effect on the community and how people interact with each other. At number 6, we have a kombu here, and that's all of the confirmed minor systems. Well, it doesn't feel right to call them minor, but whatever.
That's a lot.
This will be the stuff such as the 1.12 Altric Valley, and the 1.12 talents and class balance, the pseudo-loot trading, no progressive itemization, and sharding for high population areas. I wanted to include all of this into one part, because I just went over these in my What We Know So Far video, so I don't want to overlap too much here, and there's really not a whole lot to say about them anyways.
I have that same
They're
shirt.
Pretty
self-explanatory. I'm gonna wear that shirt next stream.
I think something worth noting is that they do have an effect on the overall balance of the game. The 1.12 talents in the Molten Core, the 1.12 versions of items.
Ooh.
Honestly, in terms of balance,
that's a big sword right there.
I'm
gonna get that first.
To some of the other things coming up on this list, but they're there. And as for layering, although limited, it will have some effect on the community. Like, maybe we won't see that absolute chaos on launch where everyone is fighting over one boar.
I think that we're still gonna see that. Like, we're still gonna see it. Like, the layering, I don't feel is gonna have any sort of a meaningful. It's not going to create any meaningful change in the launch experience. Now, I hope, I mean, like, maybe this is just hopeful thinking or wishful thinking, but I don't feel like it will, because there's just going to be so many people playing the game.
So, sort of combining these all together, I have my number 6 on my list. Getting into the nitty-gritty, though, at number 5, we have the phase schedule instead of the patch cycle. We, of course, had 12 major content patches for
Mysteries
Vanilla
of
from 1.1 to 1.12, and also including the more minor patches for the little stuff like class balance,
and also
bug fixes, and
of
item rebalancing, and so on. Each one of these incrementally introduced more and more features and systems, and evolved the game to its ultimate 1.12 state.
Serviceability? Yeah, it is.
In this patch, they finally introduced dungeon caps, so you couldn't bring 40 people to run through them anymore.
Fucking sucks.
And in this one, they added the Stranglethorn Vale fishing tournament.
Oh.
Or maybe they linked the auction houses in this one. For the re-release, however, the way they're delivering the content is quite different. Instead, opting for a 6-phase schedule,
I think they're
sticking
doing it
with
right.
the most major game
I still
updates
do.
To mark each one.
I'm very confident.
It's pretty close, and it has the most major stuff covered, but it's not exact. Raid releases, the PvP system, battlegrounds, a selection of profession recipes, and so on. Everything else, however, such as the class balance and itemization, will be in their 1.12 state right from the get-go, which will 5.
Oh, wait. Shit, I didn't mean to click that. That's totally my bad. I fucked up there. Okay, where was it? It's like right here, right? Yeah, I was gonna pause. And I was gonna pause and say something, but I forgot because this messed me up.
Such as the class balance and itemization will be.
Itemization, that's right. So itemization, obviously, like there are certain items that are like really, really good at the end of the game, like blue items that are like outpacing raid items, which is kind of a weird dynamic to have, and it shouldn't necessarily be in the game. But I think Blizzard just opted to do that because it would be simpler for players. And while it is unfortunate, it's also just kind of a reality. Press the space bar. No, that's going to make me jump. I don't want to jump.
1.12 state right from the get-go, which will certainly have a large impact on how the game plays. So, the phase schedule, number 5 on our list. And coming in at number 4, we have stagnation. As far as we know right now, Blizzard has no plans of updating the game to its Burning Crusade release, or emulating the cycle of previous expansions, meaning that once we get through all of the phases, and once we clear through Nexramas, you've, quote, beaten the game, if there is such a thing for an MMO.
I love how everybody just assumes that, like, everybody's gonna beat Nax. You know what I mean? Like, oh, well, once you beat Nax, like, just assuming that you're gonna be in a raiding guild for that long, that you're gonna get all the way up to 60, that you're gonna farm out all the resistance gear, that you're gonna do the reputations, that you're gonna do the attunements, you're gonna do all these fucking things, right? And then, oh, well, yeah, after you complete, you know, what's equivalent to 1,000 hours of gameplay, well, then there's no more vertical progression. Wow, I guess the game sucks, right? Give me a fucking break. Most people are not going to clear Nax because they won't have the time. I think most people that set aside the time and try to will probably clear Nax, but that's a lot of time. That's a lot of investment. I don't know if that's going to happen.
Recently, there was mention of possibly bringing in new content, but there's conflicting information about that, and it's potentially years away, so I don't want to give too much credit to it right now. But this is another highly...
Let me read this.
...new content.
If fans have a desire for something, it would be absolutely be considered. We're certainly not planning to do that today, but if people want more, we can talk about that. Honestly, that's the best answer they can give. Like, that is the smartest, best answer they can give. We'll see what's going to happen. Like, if they do something like OSRS, I am just so worried about them messing it up, man. Like, I'm so worried. I don't know if they will. I hope they won't, but I'm so worried that they will. Yeah, this does sound like me. So let's talk about, let's see, it would absolutely be considered. That's a non-promissory thing, that's no non-committal. We're certainly not planning to do that today, right? So that means that it still leaves the option for people that really want it to interpret that as it might happen and still give them hope. So there's another non-committal statement. But if people want more, we can talk about that. Another non-committal statement. So this post, this statement could have been made completely by me. Like I totally could have done this right here.
But there's conflicting information about that, and it's potentially years away, so I don't want to give too much credit to it right now.
Okay.
But this is another highly debated subject of the game.
Yeah, we talk about
one side
it every fucking
says
day.
That they can play Classic forever, and you can always start new alts or just turn towards PvP if you feel like you've outgeared the PvE.
Ooh, I like that quote.
And the other side says that MMOs live and die on updates and content patches, and with that eventual stagnation, what's keeping players playing? I consider myself part of the former crowd, but just the knowledge of the game eventually stagnating will certainly have an effect on how players conduct themselves. The perfect example I can give you is the timeline between Nexramas and the Burning Crusade.
Okay.
As I mentioned, I raided fairly hardcore back then. We cleared through all of the Molten Core, Onyxia, and the Blackwing Lair, of course, and all of the AQ-40 save C'Thun.
Wow.
And as for
That's
Nexramas, we did all of the entry-level stuff.
Holy
all of the
shit.
Spider Wing, and maybe like one boss in the remaining three wings.
Damn!
We didn't
That's
get
big.
Super far in it, because fewer and fewer people were showing up every week. Part of this was just because
Sounds
of the
like
general
retail.
Burnout, and the rest of it was because of the Burning Crusade.
Yep.
Everyone knew that this new amazing expansion was right around the corner, and it was common knowledge that the level cap would be increased. Thus, any gear that we get now really doesn't have any longevity. So it was sort of like, what's the point of grinding our skulls against a brick wall if in a few months we'll be replacing them with greens? What's the point of the ring?
what's the point of farming out Titan forges and raid gear if in just a couple of months we'll be replacing it with normal mode raid gear from the next raid? I mean, they literally do. I mean, they the same thing that created apathy in players over 10 years ago, like 15 years ago at this point, they're doing it again. But instead of this time a new expansion coming out that people can at least be excited for, it's some new dipshit raid that's going to be cleared on the first day by anybody with a group that has half a brain. I mean, it's actually so funny that Blizzard made this mistake, and now they make them... They made this mistake, and now they make that exact same mistake every 5 months.
14 grind, if all of the gear will be worthless when the Burning Crusade launches.
I actually farmed out as much
myself,
of that as I could.
My guild,
so I had
many
it for
others,
BC.
I'm sure,
it's complete
to
waste
sort of,
of
coast
time.
Their way through the rest of vanilla and recharge their batteries for our adventures into the Outland. So, with no Burning Crusade, players no longer have that excuse, and they will eventually get the best items for every slot.
That's gonna be me.
And have no need to raid other
yep,
than
that's
just
me right
for
there,
the fun
100%.
Of it, which may or may not be enough for them.
The literal god.
So, stagnation, number 4 on our list. And coming in at number 3, we have knowledge and access to information. I mentioned earlier how in terms of balance, I think things such as the 1.12 class balance and itemization are just
it's
a
just
drop
a
in the ocean. That they're
it's
eclipsed
just a straight reality.
By other things in this list. This is one of them. So first, let's address the player's personal knowledge of the game. The game, in one form or another, has been out for 14 years. Just talking MMOs in general here, back then, it was a hot and trending genre. World of Warcraft was the first MMO for many people, and sometimes even their first game, period. Back then, a very small percentage of people had maybe a few year precedent to work with, but now we have millions and millions with a 15-year precedent, and it'll greatly affect how we actually play it. This time, we know that Spirit kind of sucks, and is mostly used for just leveling, or that hybrid specs aren't all that powerful. We know
that
warriors are the best tanks, and
we knew
know
that
just
back
how powerful
then too.
Weapon skill is, and that warlocks are hindered by the debuff limit, or
yep.
what races go best with what classes, and people will roll different classes accordingly to suit their needs and
I just want to say right now is that I think that a lot of the reasons why people think things are undertuned in Classic right now is because of this. Is because people are just so much better at playing the game now, especially the people that are playing beta. Like, obviously, whenever you actually release Classic out to the general player base, you're going to have Billy the dipshit that runs in there and aggroes 3 kobolds into mines for 2 hours and then quits the game. But whenever you actually have the good players, the people that have played the game for like 15 years or something like that, they know everything about the game. Maybe they're not rank 1 raiders, but they understand the game on a very fundamental level, and they have that muscle memory to where they just know what buttons to press, and they have that instinct of, okay, let's do this and do that. Because of those things, I think that players have gotten so good that people are perceiving Classic as being bugged because of how much better players are now than they used to be. Like, that's generally the way I feel. Okay, now if the mob scaling and like the elite damage and all of this other stuff is actually true and it is fucked up, but, you know, I don't know. The fuck is this? DC'd again? Okay, just a minute. Let me finish the video.
Game activities. Players know every single nook and cranny of every single nook and cranny of the game. It's impressive how knowledgeable some people are. And even if you don't know much yourself, these are going to be your guildmates and fellow raid members. Back then, I made a dwarf paladin because they were just swole. Whoa. Look at the muscles on this guy.
He's a big boy.
He must do a lot of damage.
Of course he
does. I didn't
does.
Know that. It was all just looks. And at the end game, I'd be spamming 5-minute buffs on 40 people for 5 hours a night. Today it's, okay, stone form. Well, I'll be PvPing, so that's why I'll pick him. But on the other
sense.
Hand, humans
yeah,
get that weapon
people are just
skill,
a lot smarter.
Which is really good for PvE.
They're just a lot smarter.
And even taking a step outside of the game, where may you find this information, you may ask? Well, at youtube.com/madseasonshow, of course. YouTube's number one spot for your favorite clinically depressed monotone YouTube user telling you how to play a game that was released 14 years ago.
Hey.
On a serious note, though, YouTube didn't exist until 2005, and even still, it would be a while before World of Warcraft videos would become a thing, let alone raid or dungeon guides.
Oh, it's beautiful, man.
You were lucky if you'd find anything other than a 240p keyboard-turning clicker PvP video edited to the tune of Drowning Pool or Slipknot.
That's all you
then,
need.
We didn't have ironclad sexy red devils providing guides on various aspects of the game. No, the best that we got were old GeoCities hosted text guides, often riddled with vague or otherwise inaccurate descriptions of
nobody knew what the fuck they were doing. That's basically
and
what he's saying.
If you were lucky,
nobody had any
possibly
idea.
Possibly explained through voice comms by your raid leader, trying in vain to guide 39 people away from Johannes' Reign of Fire.
Okay, Lenny, you know what to do. You did great last time. Same as you, Omni. So make a pull just
here we go.
As that one.
Here we go.
Hunters, stay ready to make a pull. And good luck, everybody. Let's get this bugger down.
You know what my guild used
There's
to do?
A fight right there.
The Warlocks would drop Rain of Fire during the fight
here we
to
go.
Mess with everyone. They were identical, so people would always scramble out of the way and wonder why it seemed to be following them. So there's a tip for all of you troublemakers out there.
That's a really good idea.
The
I'm going to do
had,
that.
Best we had, honestly, was Thoughtbot.
No, he's smart.
Which is like the less hot cousin of your crush. WoWhead only really took off during the Burning Crusade, I want to say.
It was like Wrath.
I think we take for granted just how useful
I
it and other similar sites can be. A complete database of the entire game, and with text guides for pretty much anything you can imagine, and also user comments to fill in the blanks. We live in the information age, where any question is answered with a simple search. And with the game now having a 14-year history behind it, it's all been documented for our convenience. I mean, we did have the internet back then. Stuff like this did exist, but not at this level, simply due to the game's decade-long history, and sites like YouTube and WoWhead hitting their stride.
It's not just that, it's people's job, literally, it's people's fucking job to teach you how to play the game. This is what they do, that's their job. They're like, hey, I'm gonna make these videos and do this stuff, so I can make money. Like, imagine if back in the day, there were people whose job it was to make videos about Molten Core. There would be millions of people doing that, and it would be completely like, I don't know, so I can make money. Yeah, like, I think that's a massive component. Like, people really kind of underestimate how much YouTube and everything has changed the way that games work now. Because, like, now, most people don't even, like, you don't go to GameStop and look at the cover of the jewel case and say, do I want this game or not? You go on YouTube and you listen to some raving person who jump cuts every 3 seconds tell you why the game sucks or it's great. And that's just completely different. And it's the same with learning how to play games, too.
So, knowledge and access to information at number 3.
Fuck yeah.
And coming in at number 2, we have skill.
He's talking about
this really
me.
Goes hand in hand with knowledge, I think, but yep. I think there are some key distinctions that warrants it its own spot here. You can have all the knowledge in the world and read up on anything, but putting it to use
Very
is
true.
A different story entirely. Like, I know the proper form for a squad. I read up on it, and I watched a lot of videos, but I can't even lift the bar. What gives? World of Warcraft hooked millions of players, and many of them have
is
been
that
playing
Ronnie Coleman?
MMOs ever since then.
God
Not only
damn.
Do they have the knowledge on how to gear their character or position themselves during boss encounters, they've been actually doing it, and it's something you can translate very easily.
Oh, I don't even
if you're
like
able
watching
to beat
that clip.
Proudmoore in the Battle of Dazur'alor, I'm pretty sure you can stay out of Johannes' Reign of Fire.
I don't
or
know
if
about
you've tanked
that.
At all within the past 10 years,
yep.
You're probably familiar with the tank swapping mechanic with the stacking debuffs.
Yeah, probably.
As I said, we all sucked back then. It seemed like 90% of the players would be keyboard turners, clickers, or backpedalers.
Even See, I'm just trying to give you guys an authentic vanilla experience. That's why I play the game that way. And I do think, actually, I genuinely think that at least tanking in dungeons in vanilla, unless you're tanking a mythic plus 20 or something, is harder than tanking dungeons in BFA. Threat is a much bigger mechanic. You have to plan things out more. Your knowledge of the dungeon is more important. You have to keep track of a lot more things. I tanked server first challenge modes for fucking Mists of Pandaria. I was one of the first people to get gold in WoD. I know what I'm talking about here with tanking. I'm not SCO, okay? Like, don't get me wrong. I'm not SCO. But I'm good enough to at least have an opinion on this, okay? And I've got a lot of I've done tanking my whole time. I think that it's harder in Classic. I do. Just because of the limited resources and everything else. This goes benched. Okay, well, whoever you want. Salute back.
If there were rank 14 Grand Marshals and High Warlords, it didn't matter. Everyone would desperately try to keyboard turn their enemies into frame as they click rend, and all with that ugly default UI. Spell batching was something that only 1% of the player base knew about, and only 1% of those players had the knowledge and skill to build strategies around it, whereas today it's pretty common knowledge, I think. Especially considering that I think most of the people who'll be playing Classic is that hardcore crowd that are heavily invested into the game.
I don't think that's true.
You ever try to help your parents navigate to their email? No matter how many times you explain it, and no matter what instructions you give, vocal or written, you're labeled as a literal god of computers because you know how to get to google.com, and as you navigate the ever-growing number of AdWord toolbars to load up their email for the 100th time, you wonder how they managed to even start their computer to begin with. These are your main healers in Classic.
My dad, it's been 10 years I've been trying to teach him how to open up the task manager and close a program. He still don't fucking know. It doesn't matter how long it's gonna take or anything. He still has no fucking idea. And I have to go over there and fix it. Like, I don't even know what to say. There was one time, I'm gonna tell a quick story, okay, for this, because I think it's really funny. My dad wakes me up in the morning. Or actually, I hear the door, like, open up really, really fast. I'm like, wait, what the fuck is going on? And I look at my phone. I had a flip phone at this time. And I had, like, 25 missed calls from my dad. And I thought to myself, I'm like, what the fuck? Did the house burn down? Like, what's going on? My dad literally fucking pushes my door open, kicks my door open. He's like, wake up. You didn't answer your phone. And I'm like, well, what's going on, Dad? He's like, and at this moment, I actually thought that my dad was just, he had finally just had enough about me not having a job and playing World of Warcraft all day, that he was going to kick my fucking ass out of bed at 7 a.m. and tell me to go up to Hobby Lobby and put in a new fucking application and make sure that I talked to the manager whenever I wear a polo shirt. So I talked to my dad about this, and then slowly I realized that actually it has nothing to do with me at all. It has to do with his computer. And my dad is extremely impatient, and he was trying to copy-paste an application or some sort of a file on his computer, and it didn't work in the first 3 seconds. So his response to that was to click the same button about 1,000 times. So after after the computer started registering all of the processes, I had to, it would just continue putting more and more of this application. So, like, imagine having your desktop where there's like a notepad document that just appears on it like every 5 seconds because my dad just kept clicking it and it was trying to process all the times that my dad clicked the button. So my dad finally asked me, he's like, okay, get the fuck over to my house right now. And I'm like, okay, fine. Give me 10 minutes and I'll drive over there. So I drive over there and it's not happening anymore. And he keeps telling me that it's the Sorcerer's Apprentice, which, if you guys don't know what that is, it's like a Disney movie where there's like a broom that cleans things up, and the broom turns into 2 brooms, and then it turns into 4 brooms and 8 brooms and, you know, 16 brooms, 32, a lot of brooms, all right? So he says the Sorcerer's Apprentice is on my computer. I go over to the house. I guess the movie ended because he's not there anymore. I restart the computer. I haven't said a single word to him. It stopped happening. And so I'm like, it's fixed. He's like, what'd you do? I said nothing. I went home. I went back to bed. Later on that day, my dad's standing next to my mom, having my mom look up Sorcerer's Apprentice virus. They didn't find anything. Never happened again. My dad, like, it's actually hilarious how many different ways my dad doesn't understand computers. Like, he got a garage door opener that had more than 2 buttons on it. He hits the wrong button all the time. But now he's got a new one now, so he doesn't need to worry about that. It's just a 1-button thing. So he can play a Rat Paladin with it, basically. Okay, let's get back to the video.
sick. These were the people who held your life in their hands. Okay.
Yeah.
Well, maybe that's a bit of an over-exaggeration.
It's not.
But it's not as far from the truth than
it's
you think.
It's not at all.
You can't just erase 14 or 15 years of experience and these raids being out for that time. And before you say, well, just blowing through them for transmog runs is way different. People aren't actually raiding them.
But is it really?
Well, my response is, oh yes, they have. Private servers have existed for years,
yep.
And they're even quite popular. Here are just a few screenshots of some in their final moments before they were shut down.
Oh, that's nostalgia, I'm pretty
sure. You can't
even
find cities as packed in the current game.
Oh my god.
And all of these people have been raiding the Molten Core, Onyxia, the Blackwing Lair,
wow.
And so on for years, many times over. And they're making up a significant portion of...
Private servers aren't accurate. They're harder than retail was. Like, literally, even the people that make the private servers say that they overtune the bosses to make up for the fact that the coding might not be perfect. Yeah, they're actually even harder. It's insane. People, like, Molten Core is going to fall over. Like, actually, I'm going to talk about that afterwards. But remind me about Molten Core on week one. Remind me about that. I'll talk about that after I finish the video.
Those that are going to play Official Classic. It's pretty insane, actually. It's like one of those Where's Waldo portraits. And most of them are raid gear. How many hundreds of thousands of hours are cumulatively invested into this one screenshot? Again, even if you don't play them yourself, these will be your raid.
If those people invested that same amount of time into medical research, we'd have cured cancer. But those epic mounts? Hey. They're pretty nice.
Members. And in the case of Nexramus, even retail players got some serious real-time rating here because it was, of course, re-released in the Wrath of the Lich King expansion.
Okay,
so,
dude.
Just like how you can't erase knowledge, you can't erase skill. I think that there'll still be some challenge, don't get me wrong, but mainly in the later tiers. Probably Nexramus and AQ40. I mean, pre-nerf C'thun was unkillable.
A little bit of BWL, too.
That. And
like Chromag might be a little
bit nerfed version. I doubt that he'll be a cakewalk. But at least for the earlier tiers, the rate at which these guilds down these raids, I believe, will be vastly accelerated.
Don't
like,
people
we're
clear
talking
MC on
week
one now?
Release,
in private servers?
The same day for the top guilds. I mean, people who were actually good at the game were 10-manning Onyxia in 2005, no less. And
they
1 year later,
they
with 1.12 talents and Nexramus gear,
yep.
It was actually 4-man, if you can believe that.
I thought it was 3.
And today,
I remember watching nearly a Night
15
Elf
years
Warrior.
Later, I think skill will play a major factor in the game, and it earns the number 2 spot in our list. So, what can possibly top that, you may ask?
Okay.
What's this mysterious number 1 game-changing thing in classic World of Warcraft?
Good computers.
That's right. No blob shadows. Or, I mean, that first-time experience. There's just something magical of entering this huge world. And not just for World of Warcraft, but the MMO genre as a whole. You don't know how many zones there are, professions, talents, what spells you'll get,
yep.
If there's PvP,
yep.
Or what the max level is, or if there even is one. You don't know what dungeons are, nor raids. You literally just stepped into this giant world with something to discover around every corner. I know this sounds similar to the knowledge section, but I think there's a distinction to be made here. There's a difference between not having a good knowledge of something and your literal first time experiencing it. And MMOs are
this
pretty unique
true.
In that regard, since
I
it's such
completely
a huge
agree with
world
this.
Filled with so many people, and especially taking into account that World of Warcraft was the first MMO for many. No longer are you restricted to that single player
world.
Is
this Morrowind?
Your typical RPG at the time, and experiencing
wow.
that for the first time was pretty overwhelming. That's the word I'm looking for. Overwhelming. If you've played any MMO today, it's nearly impossible to get this feeling again, I think, because you
BFA's
now know what
more overwhelming
about
than classic.
And what to expect.
Let's be honest.
You truly can't recreate any moment in life, really. If you have prior knowledge or experience, you're doomed because you lose that magic of things just happening in the moment, like the first time you rode a bike, your first kiss, your first strip club, or your first concert. And it'll absolutely be true for a classic World of Warcraft.
I've never been to a strip
it'll
club.
It'll still be a great experience,
never.
And I'm going to savor every last moment of it.
I think they're disgusting.
But once you open that bottle, so to speak, it's open. These moments are special, and the people, places, and things tied to them are just as special because we know
Fuck
that
yeah, they
can never be truly replicated.
Fuck yeah, they are.
So, That's my personal
top 10
list. You can
never have that again. It's
things that'll be different in the recreation of classic World of Warcraft. Some of them are in Blizzard's control, and some of them aren't. I know there's always the changes versus no changes argument, and the purpose of this video isn't to add fuel to that fire. I just thought that it was an interesting subject, and I wanted to share what I was thinking about. Even through all of this, I'm still extremely hyped for the game, and I'll be playing day one, of course, but I'm also realistic of what to expect and what not to expect. If anything,
I
hope that this video
that
shed light in some things that maybe you didn't think about. Like it if you liked it, and I'll see you in the next one.
That was a good motherfucking ass video, dude. Like, let's be honest. I love that video. Holy shit, man.
Farewell for now, mortals. We hope you enjoyed today's video.
God damn, dude. I was getting hyped just listening to that. Damn, man. I'll link the video in chat, okay? This is the one that we just watched. Watch the MC. Just give me a minute for the Molten Core thing, okay? Just a second here. Like, I really, really like this video. It's fucking amazing, and I hope that more people actually start doing that more often, and, like, you know, we start seeing more videos.